Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Novaspirit Tech, and welcome back to my studio. So today we're going to be taking a look at the HiKey 960. Now before we begin, I gotta say that LeMaker sent me this board to do a review, but they're not paying me or sponsoring me for this video. So with that out of the way, let's get started. So you basically got a 4-core Cortex A73 and then a 4-core Cortex A53, which is a big little CPU architecture type thing. So it's technically got octa-core or 8-core. Is that how you say it? Yeah. And then you got the Mali G72, which is a pretty powerful graphic card on here. 3 gigs of RAM, 32 gigabytes of flash storage, 2 USB type A ports, and 1 USB type C, which I am actually pretty impressed because it's moving forward to this type of port. HDMI and SD card for either storage or you could actually boot off this image. Now the exciting part about this card is actually the back. I actually was very interested in doing a review on this board because of this PCIe Gen 2 M2 connector. Now I could actually take one of these little chip thingies and actually plug in a PCIe device. So I could basically put in a graphic card on this thing and have it mine Bitcoin or something. So that's pretty cool. And that's what I was really excited about. Now this does come preloaded with Android AOSP, if I did that correctly. Yeah. And it is supported by Google. So they actually get development from the Google side itself and Linaro. So you could actually do Linux and stuff too. Now, with that being said, this is actually an Android development board. So don't compare this to a Raspberry Pi because it is basically two different types of things. Now it does have a 40 pin low speed connector and I don't find much documentation on it, so I don't know how to really use it. And there's a 60 pin high speed connector on top. So again, I don't know where I could find documentation. And the most I read about it is that there isn't even I2C connection working on this thing. So trying to plug in a screen on this 40 pin connector will be a problem. It does use 12 volts. And I don't know why they opted for 12 volts because this is basically a phone and phones use like 5 volts, and that's a lot. And a lot of my stuff cannot connect to this 12 volt. You only could use AC power. Now this is a little bit faster than Samsung S7. So you could, I guess, figure out the benchmarks from there. I'm not really going to do a benchmark because I wanted to get out of Android development as fast as possible. Now here's the thing. I try to throw Linux on this and I've been trying for the past week. I've been having so much issues. I can't get anything to boot. Now, reading on the forum, which not much support over there, but on the forums, they basically said, because we can't get the UEFI working, we're not pushing the Linux operating system out yet. Meanwhile, their website says Android and Linux. So that's one bad thing. Two, I emailed them and it took them, I think, a couple of days for them to email me back, and they actually gave me a link to an image, which doesn't work. I tried 9,000 different ways to install it, and every time that I did, it won't boot up. Then I try to roll back into the latest version of Android, that won't boot up. Well, it does boot up, but it doesn't have a screen, it doesn't detect my monitor, and I'm not the only one with that issue. So all in all, this is basically a paperweight right now. I can't do anything with it. I'm not giving up on it. I'm gonna wait until the Linux does come out, and then I'm gonna try to put a graphic card on this. But in the meantime, I couldn't get anything to work. Now, the worst part of this being an Android development board is that you have to load your programs using the USB-C port, all right? So I understand that. Now I got the USB-C cable, plugged it into my computer and plugged it in here. I shot a program over, and here's the problem. Once you have a USB-C connection going, the other ports, the USB-A ports, does not work. So that means I can't interface with it. Meaning, as soon as I plug in a program, I can see the debug screen. I can't click on anything because the other USB ports won't work, so my keyboard doesn't work. If I unplug my USB-C cable, my keyboard works, but I lose my debugging. So this is a terrible Android development board. I can't even debug on it. So I don't know what you guys were thinking on this. It's, oh, here's the catch. $239. This is $239. Can you believe that? Anyway, let me know what your thoughts are on this board. Leave it in the comments below. If you haven't done so already, hit that little subscribe button and that little bell notification icon so you know when the next video is going to be out. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.